Hi everyone, I'm Rob from Project Sandbox. In this video, I'm going to show you how to export your final video project when you're done creating one. So to export your final project, what you actually want to do is first review your project to make sure it's exactly what you want it to be. So make sure that there's no items hidden off on the end or anything like that, because that'll increase the time it takes to export your final project. If you're happy with the way it looks though, your next step is just to click this button right here. If you notice when I hover over it, it says export video. So if you click on that, you'll see this window pop up. This window will allow you to change the name of your video project and where your video project saves to. I normally like it just to save to the desktop of my computer, but feel free to save it wherever you would really like. From there, you'll see that there's two different options that we can choose from to look into. One is a simplified version and one is the advanced version. Clicking on profile, you can see that there's kind of some templates set up to export your video in certain ways to say if it's for DVD, web, or Blu-ray. And then underneath it, you'll see a bunch of different options available to you. If you remember, in the very first video that I showed you, or rather the video that we started the project, we set up a video profile. This is where your video profile kind of gets put to at the end of your project. So if you set this up properly, you won't need to change anything right there. If you do need to change it though, you just need to click on it and select the option that you want to actually use. The one thing that I do want to point out to you is this target area right here. So I have it set up as MPH.264. So what this is a video codec. Don't worry too much about what a video codec does. Just be mindful that really the main point of it is it's something that's going to put your video together and it's going to influence the final file type of your video. The one I would suggest you should use most of the time, especially if you're just using high definition footage, so like the 1920 by 1080p, is just this H.264. If you do want to experiment a little bit though, feel free to try out H.265 MP4, or you can try out this H.264 QSV. If for some reason you do need a specific file type though for whatever your final video actually creates, you can see the file type first right here. So if you notice, these first three are AVI, this one's FLV, MKV, MOV, so a bunch of different types of file types. And then on the right hand side is the codec that it uses. Like I said though, I'm going to stick with this MP4 H.264 because I have this 1080p footage. And then finally at the bottom, you'll see the quality of the footage. Depending on where this footage actually sits, you might want to try to modify the quality of the footage. So right now this is high quality, but say if you were putting it on the web or you were putting it in a place that should have a smaller file size, you can try dropping it to medium or low to get it below that threshold of file size that you're trying to send it for. For instance, if you're trying to send it over email, you'll have that 50 megabyte limit a lot of the time. So high might just be too big of a file size to allow for that. Going into this a little further though, we can click on this advanced setting. So advanced is where it'll give you more control of how your final video is exported. Most of the time, I wouldn't suggest you need to go into advanced, but just to get a better sense of what that option actually is, I'm gonna go through it with you. So if you notice at the very first option, it's saying export to video and audio. But this is where you can actually just export the audio for your video that you created, or just the video, or if you just want a sequence of images. So say if you just want a whole bunch of JPEGs of all of your frames, that's where you could go about doing that. From here, this is where you could establish your starting frame and your ending frame. So say if you wanted just your video to be from frame 20 to 300, this is where you could specify that to trim the end and beginning of your video a little bit. Going into profile, you'll notice that we have that familiar text drop-down box right there. This is where you could manually manipulate the width and height of your video. So say if we want it to be 1,000 pixels across and 1080 high, not sure why we would want to do it, but if you wanted to, you could manipulate it there. You can play with the aspect ratio, pixel ratio, or even the frame rate right there. I wouldn't suggest playing around with this stuff that much unless you're really familiar with what each of those options does. If we were exporting it as an image sequence, so that very first option right there, this is where you could manipulate how that actually works. And then we go into video settings where you can actually play with the video format, video codecs, bitrate, and then your audio as well. So your sample rate would be important for that. If, say, you wanted to make sure that your video was even a lower file size than what simple or low would allow, you could actually manipulate the bitrate here. And if you need it to be a smaller file size, you could lower it. If you want it to be a better quality video, so say you notice it's really pixelated and you want it to be a little bit better, you could increase that bitrate, and that will manipulate your final video. I'm gonna do a really low bitrate though, just to see what it'll look like. And then I'm gonna hit export video. I'm going to fast forward the video because sometimes exporting can take a little bit of time. So if you're in a hurry, make sure that you export your video well in advance, because I've exported videos that have taken a couple hours to go through the whole process. Since this one's so short though, it shouldn't take that long. All right, so once your video is done exporting, it'll say 100% right here. It'll tell you the time elapsed that it actually took, and we'll just hit done here. So the only other thing that I wanted to mention to you that you should make sure that you do before you call your video good is just to preview it. So this is what my video looks like. So we got the title, does the crazy cat zoom in? We got some nice clouds. And we can see it more or less worked the way we wanted it to. If you can see it on your screen, you might be able to. There is some little artifacting right in here, just some little pixelation. So if I wanted to get rid of that, that's when I would bump up that bitrate. So I hope that helped you understand how exporting works a little bit. The whole process is just basically a way to put your whole video together to create that final simple one file file, which you can give to people in a variety of ways. Thank you very much for watching the video. As always, if you need help, you know where to find me. I do have one more video in this series for you to watch, and this is what will show you how to connect Blender and Inkscape to OpenShot. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.